Hello and welcome everyone. Welcome to my another playlist. And in this playlist, we are going to cover a lot, I will say, because we are going to talk about React latest features. We are going to talk about Apollo client, Apollo server, and different implementation of Apollo server with the different kind of applications. So it's going to be a big playlist. So I will be dividing into the multiple parts. So first of all, what we are going to do is first we will try to understand what is Apollo. And how this Apollo is just a vendor, and how this GraphQL implementation is provided by Apollo. There is Apollo client, there is Apollo server. So before all doing this, we will just try to understand how GraphQL works, how it is different from REST and all. These are the basic things. So we will just started with the how to write basic GraphQL server with Express using Apollo implementation. So once we have our GraphQL queries are ready, the GraphQL, everything is ready from the backend, then we will come back to our frontend. And what we will do is we will try to integrate Apollo client for GraphQL with the React.js. So that is another part. So we divided it into the two different sections. And then third section, which is important one, is why we need to write a GraphQL. If we already have a REST APIs, then can we just create a middleware on top of it and can use the GraphQL queries at the client side? So that is also a different perceptions which we need to build. You should not be writing, okay, consider a scenario that your company is already having a lot of REST APIs for application, but you wanted to move to a GraphQL. GraphQL, the main advantage of GraphQL on top of REST is it is providing aggregation, right? And it is giving you what you want, not less or not more, right? So you, in that particular case, you don't need to build the GraphQL implementation from scratch. You can just expose the REST interface through GraphQL. Okay, that is the one part. And if you're writing something from the scratch, like you are going to build some application from the scratch, that in that case, you can, what you can do is you can write the GraphQL server from scratch. You might be connecting to the MySQL, MongoDB type, or whatever the different data source you have. Right, but if you have already have the REST implementation there, then you should not be writing the GraphQL implementation from scratch. You can use GraphQL as a middleware, right? So first of all, what is GraphQL? So GraphQL, these are some of the co-authors. And so this was the GraphQL timeline, like 2012, Facebook supported the mobile network team. So they thought of, okay, using like GraphQL just to take care of the network limitations on the small scale devices. Okay, then they open source the GraphQL specifications. Then in 2016, they had a summit and then proposal came into the picture. Okay, this is the specification we can use. So the standard specification was approved among the open source contributors. And now they came up with the GraphQL.org. Now, currently for the GraphQL implementation, there are many vendors. I mean, they are providing their own implementation on a common specific rules. Okay, so it's not like they have changed the GraphQL implementation. Across the framework, it is same, only the implementation-wise, it is different. So Express has its own Express GraphQL, Apollo has its own Apollo Express GraphQL. All these different vendors are there. So we should be able to use the GraphQL at the server side. And if we are using GraphQL at the server side, we need to just tweak our client a little bit to make the GraphQL queries, because GraphQL queries will be HTTP post only. The underlying implementation is HTTP only. So we create a GraphQL server using Apollo implementation, then GraphQL client using Apollo implementation with the React, Angular, Vue.js, and we'll be just making a call and we'll be making data. So GraphQL, you can consider that GraphQL, okay, for a comparison, you can use the GraphQL server as a REST server. Okay, here it is supporting only two type of requests. Okay, query and mutation. Query means you wanted to get some data. Mutation means you wanted to update some data. So it is supporting indirectly get and post, just for terminology. But every request to the GraphQL is always post. In post, what we do, we send a query, mutation, subscription, all these things we will be able to send. And currently it is available for everything. Either you write Java, PHP, Node.js, TypeScript, Ruby, everywhere you can see this GraphQL language. And in the HTTP or REST language, we are talking about the REST endpoint, HTTP GET PUT POST PATCH. In the terminology of GraphQL, we will be talking about query. So we'll be making this particular query and we'll be getting the data from the APIs. Okay, Now, solution architectures, like how we are going to do it. So these are the possible clients. I mean, you will be using the React, Angular, Vue.js, and what you will be doing, you will be integrating it with the Apollo client. Okay, now my client is ready. At the server side, you can use the same Apollo implementation, Apollo GraphQL server, and your server is ready. Now you will be able to talk to each other. Okay, so the demo and all we'll talk later, like the actual implementation. So what GraphQL is? GraphQL is managing the schema of the data which it is going to send to the client. Okay, that schema may be like user data. Based on that schema, we are creating a queries and mutations. So these are the schema types. Okay, int, float, string, boolean. It is supporting all these things. Okay, and there are GraphQL tools. You can create a schema out of it, and you can expose the APIs GraphQL queries from there. GraphIQL is just a portal, or you can see the web interface using which you will be able to execute the query and mutation against the GraphQL server. Like GraphQL Hub, here you are mentioning the GraphQL query, and this GraphQL query is going in the form of HTTP post to the GraphQL server, and GraphQL server is responding us with a response. Okay, other thing is, once we have set up the GraphQL backend using Apollo GraphQL server, then Apollo Express server, then you can look at the client side, because we are not writing the REST, okay, so that you can make Axios request or fetch call to get the data. We have to do some particular implementation to create the client instance, and then we will be able to make a query and mutations. Query means fetching the data from the GraphQL server. Mutation means you might be updating some record, you might be creating some record. In that case, you will be calling that as a mutation. Mutation means changing the state. Okay, so I mean, in the separate videos, we'll be talking about the React. Okay, how you can set up an Apollo client at the React side to make to send a request to the GraphQL backend. Like you will be sending GraphQL queries and GraphQL mutations. So we might be using these modules, Apollo client, React Apollo, Apollo tag. We'll be just creating the client. This is my GraphQL endpoint. Okay, I got the Apollo client instance. Now through this Apollo client interface, so just pass this Apollo client interface in your component as a provider. That should be somewhere. Yes, this in the provider, like we have the Redux store. Similarly, you pass the client, and then once this client is available to everywhere, then you will be just able to make the call to the queries, client.query, client.mutation and all. It's not going to the details about how we are doing it, but this is how we are making. We are making query, we are making mutation to our interface. So why use GraphQL? So this is my first video, and here I will be focusing on, don't jump to the implementation. Okay, I need to use GraphQL. I don't like REST and all. GraphQL has its pros and cons. REST has its pros and cons. Both are best at their own places. Okay. Now, consider that you are planning to migrate to GraphQL and you already have a REST API. So it's unnecessary that you write the whole implementation from scratch in GraphQL. What you can do is, you can use GraphQL as a middleware, and you can just make an API call. You can make a call from that GraphQL middleware to these REST endpoints, and your front end will still be a Apollo React client, because that will be sending the GraphQL queries and mutation. Your middleware is now using GraphQL, so it will be able to respond. But when you are making a project from scratch and you don't want this middleware concept or API gateway kind of concept using GraphQL, then you can just write your backend from scratch in the GraphQL using Apollo GraphQL server. You write your queries, mutations, you define your schema, and you start your server. Okay, so the code for the GraphQL Express server look like similar to what we are doing in the Express, only we just need to have the type definitions and schema. Okay, so we are making some requests like query and mutation from client side, so those we need to define somewhere, and our server need to be bootstrapped with the all available queries at the backend, all available mutation at the backend. From a simple terminology, this is how it works. Now when we write it, then we will understand, okay, what all things we need. Okay, so thanks everyone. I hope we can start the GraphQL implementation. So first we will talk about is base writing the basic GraphQL server using Apollo implementation. There we will just cover some basic user routes, or you can see the user queries and user mutations. Okay, Then once we have some data ready, because I will be using MongoDB for persisting the data, I will be just creating some APIs, some queries. I should not be using the APIs. Here we are talking about in terms of query and mutation. I'll be talking to the MongoDB, I'll be writing some routes. So I will be exposing some queries and mutations. Those queries and mutation will play around using GraphQL tool, that how to hit those queries. Then we will implement a GraphQL Apollo client with React or Angular, and then we will start making a call. That is the approach one. What if I already have a REST APIs created? Then we will just using GraphQL middleware, and we will be making an API call to the REST interface and responding it to the client. Okay, so we talked a lot. Now it's time to go to action. So you can subscribe to my channel. I already covered a lot of things about GraphQL, about React, Angular, Redux. Everything in JavaScript is on my YouTube channel. I'm not spamming. I mean, you can just check it out. Okay, and this playlist is going to be used. Let's get started. Thanks, everyone.